If there's one reason why you take notes, it's obviously because you'd like to be able to get back to them later on. So what good is a note-taking app if you cannot instantly find those notes you need at the moment? And this is why in Agenda 19 we focused on search and made it a lot simpler to use and at the same time much more powerful. And how we did that, I'd love to show you now. So if you're looking for a particular note, you might remember which date it was taken on, or which people were involved, or which project it was part of. And while you could already search on these properties in Agenda, we also felt that it wasn't the best experience and that this was the area that we could improve the app the most. So let me introduce you to the new search in Agenda 19. At first, everything looks familiar and nothing much has changed. But if I go to the loop next to the plus button, you'll see that instead of a text field, we now have a little floating window show up. If I search here, for instance, on the word sun, it immediately shows me all the results in my entire library, instantly, super fast. It's smart enough to recognize that this stargazing project is the one I have already visible, so it will always show the results from that project first. Importantly, it doesn't change from where I was, so if I cancel the search, I'm still where I was before. If I click on one of the results, it jumps me to that result. But notice that when I clicked on any of the results, at the top, a new item appeared that allows me to jump straight back to where I started my search. That way, I will never lose track of where I was before I started looking for something. Now, while I was looking for the word sun, you also notice that one of the hits was these flight details from Nepal. And that's because it contains the word Sunday. So, of course, sun is also part of Sunday. But if I really only want to look for the word sun, what I can do is put the word sun in quotes. That way, it will only look for hits of exactly the word sun, leading to these two results only. So let's look at another example. Let me search for Yak Research. What you notice is that every time I hit a space between two words, it creates one of these orange so-called tokens. We'll take a look at what you can do with those later. But by default, every time you hit space, one of those tokens is created. And that's because if I look for the words Yak Research, it looks for any notes in which the word Yak and Research are found together. So for instance, this first hit has these words in the title. But you also notice that the next hit only has the word research in the title and probably the word yak is found somewhere else. So again, if I want to really specifically look for the notes that contain the words yak research together, I can put them into quotes. And now only this one note is found. The new search uses Spotlight under the hood, which means that you can now also search the notes in Agenda by using Spotlight directly from the menu bar, even if Agenda is not running. So let's have a look at something that occurs a lot in my library. For instance, just the word yak. Indeed, it gives a lot of results. In fact, there is even one note that's in the bin. But how do I now find the exact note that I need? Well, first it recognizes that I've also used a tag named yak in my notes. So if I click on this suggestion, it will only look for notes that have that particular tag, which already narrows it down quite a lot. But those were not the ones I was looking for. So let's go one step back. So this is where these two buttons on the right side of this search field are coming in handy. Imagine that I still remember that I wrote this note last week. I can go to this calendar item and actually see that I have notes that were dated on the 9th and the 10th, as well as earlier today. I can either click a single date or select the date range by clicking the first date, holding the shift key and selecting the last date, and click filter. And now I'm showing all the notes from last week with the word yak in it. There it is. The second way I can quickly narrow down search results is using this other button next to the one from the calendar. This one gives me a list of commonly used filters that I can use to quickly narrow down a certain subset of my results. For instance, I can search for anything that's on the agenda. I can even narrow down on the color of the node, whether the node contains to-do items, or only nodes that I've recently edited, for instance, this week. There, that narrows it down. And once I've found my node, I can just click anywhere to just miss the search. But what's nice is that anytime I want to return to my search, I can click the loop icon again, and my search is still there, making it very easy to go through a list of nodes that meet a certain criteria. Now, if I want to focus on only a certain type of nodes, for instance, only nodes with to-do items, so the ones that I'm showing here, I can actually activate this search as a so-called filter. The loop icon now changes into this filter icon. And now only those nodes that fulfill the criteria of my search are shown. And this is even true if I switch between projects, temporarily hiding any nodes that are not relevant at the moment. A great way to focus on those nodes that you're looking for while not getting distracted from anything else. If I want to return back to the normal state, I just hit the filter button again and all my nodes become visible. Now, if you remember how things were in the previous versions of Agenda, the combination of the new search window and the filtering options replaces the way search worked before. It's now much faster, doesn't switch you around, and keeps you focused on what's important. And given that search now by default searches all your projects, it also means we no longer need the search all entry in the sidebar. In fact, we've replaced it by an overview that has been by far the most requested, which is a way to see all the to-do items across all your nodes in Agenda. Now, so far I've shown you everything on my Mac, but as you are used from us, it works exactly the same way on your iPad and on your phone as well, where it can be even more important to quickly find those nodes that you're looking for. Also on the iPhone, at first glance, nothing much seems to have changed. The search icon is still there on the top left corner, but if I tap it, I get a very similar experience as I've just shown you on the Mac. Search works in a very similar way. I get instant results. I can also narrow down the results using the preset search options or the calendar. Notice that if I tap a result, I jump straight to that node. And of course, also on iPhone, the sidebar now features the new to-do overview. Now, the ability to find all the checklist items in your nodes that haven't been completed yet was such a popular request that we decided to give it a permanent place in the sidebar. But you can actually make these kind of overviews yourself as well. If you find that you do the same search over and over again, you can save that search as a so-called smart overview. Now, before I show you how to create a smart overview, note that this is one of the features that you get when you subscribe to the so-called premium features of Agenda, a set of features that make the app a lot more powerful and that helps you get most out of the app. But importantly also, it's through these features that you support me and Drew in continuing to improve Agenda, like we do today with search or to add the new features that you've been asking for. And so we hope that that alone is already a good reason to get these features. Now back to smart overviews. So I regularly check what nodes I need to be looking at for my work tomorrow. I can of course search for them specifically here. Wouldn't it be great if I could just have this as a permanent overview in my sidebar? You can do this by creating a smart overview. I can give the overview a name, and I can also say whether I want to show nodes that are specifically assigned to tomorrow or to an absolute date. Of course, I want this overview to shift along with the current date, so I'll choose the first option. And I click Save. This overview now appears in the sidebar and will be kept up to date also tomorrow and the day after. And one tip, if you don't want to save an overview permanently into the sidebar, you can create a temporary one in a separate window instead if you hold the Alt Option key. You can create smart overviews for any type of search you can do. Speaking of which, so far what you've seen is just the tip of the iceberg, because you can actually search for a whole variety of properties of a node. And this is where these tokens come in. So remember that I showed you that each word is automatically converted into one of those orange tokens. I can click on any of these tokens and configure exactly how I want this word to be sought for. For instance, whether something has to start with this word, end with this word, has to be exactly the word, but also whether this word needs to be present or it can optionally present. For instance, if I make it optional, I now get any node that has the word sun or the word moon in it. Or I can say, show me any nodes in which the sun is present, but the word moon is not. And I can say that the word sun should be exactly appearing as is, and not also show nodes that contain the word Sunday, for example, as I've shown earlier with the quotes. Similarly, I can decide what agenda should be looking for exactly while searching for a certain token. For example, anything that contains yak, or whether I'm only looking for the tag yak. There's a whole list of properties you can search for, from title to person, from category to project, but also on dates, on the status of a node, or whether it contains certain content, like code or quotes. You can even search for a number of presets, like nodes that are happening right now or are upcoming. And we made all of this accessible in the exact same way as it works when you're typing your nodes through the autocomplete system. If I click the loop icon or type a backslash character, I can now start typing the properties I want to search on. For instance, I can just search for nodes with the word yak in the title this way. And if I type a hashtag, it automatically starts showing my frequently used tags and completes them as I type. I can even search for nodes with a certain type of attachment or nodes with a certain color. And just as I showed how you can make certain search words optional or be excluded, you can also achieve the same by typing the so-called binary search operators that you're probably familiar with. For example, I can search for all the nodes that have been assigned to Tom or to Janice. And if that weren't enough, you can even group tokens and make even more complicated searches. There are so many options, but no worries, we have a complete overview in the Agenda community where you can find the exact search syntax.
I think it's safe to say that the possibilities are endless. You can create the most complex queries that you want, save them as an overview, and you'll always have those nodes that you need available to you at exactly the right time. Still, we also think that the new search in Agenda is a great example of the philosophy that we try to apply when we develop the app, which is that in the basis, search has become a lot simpler. It's faster to find the nodes that you need without losing context within the app. And this is the philosophy that Drew and I try to apply when we develop the app, both when it comes to the existing feature set, like we did today with search and making it a lot better, as well as the new things we're working on, like the stuff Drew is already building that builds on top of the new search that will be part of Agenda 20 and which hopefully won't take too long after this one, because this was quite a bit of work. Now, if you'd like to stay up to date on anything Agenda, be sure to subscribe to this channel and visit us on the Agenda community, where Drew and I are always around and would love to hear your feedback, whether it's things you're missing, things that are working great or less so, let us know, because we always like to take it along while working on the next updates of Agenda. Until that time, enjoy this update and see you next time. Bye bye.